So this is the nicest part.
It's great!
Not as bad as I expected.
Y'all acted like it was gonna be a death trap. I like all the natural light.
The ceiling looks great. The floors need a little refinishing, but they're beautiful.
I really like the natural pine.
I love the natural pine. I would love to make that a thing. But I think this would make a great dining room.
A little bit small for a dining room.
Well, this is a triplex.
It would be great if we could connect all of these front rooms by opening up cased openings between these three rooms.
To explain that.
Walk out of door number three, we're gonna go to door number two now.
Yeah. Now this is tricky.
Step where you see Joyce.
But also step quickly.
Well, that's more of the dining room, and now you're in the kitchen.
Oh man.
Don't you want to serve food from this room?
So
tell us about it.
Is it closed off?
No.
No.
This would all be kitchen area.
Okay.
And to have the counter that goes around here and wraps around there, because these walls would both be gone. And then you're open to that dining room over there. We'll fill it with all sorts of mismatched tables and chairs and make some sort of division in the room, like a cool wall divider. And it would be cool to have a beautiful menu board. And then over here, you would have the restroom for your customers.
Behind a wall.
Behind a wall, yes. I would just imagine this feeling. Woodsy is the word I keep going back to. Like if Ernest Hemingway had a house in Mississippi, that's the feeling I would want.
I like it.
This cafe to have.
Rugged coziness.
Rugged and cozy, I like that.
As far as like demo in the front room, just getting the junk out of there. This paneling is really being a pain. They put a lot of nails in it. The house is very sturdy.
Look at this, that's 8 penny nails on every board.
And they've been in there for 100 years. It's gonna be real slow going. So it's gonna take forever because you got 10 layers of this that we're gonna have to remove.
It's not what I wanted to see on the first day. So we're saving the cabinets.
Stop.
Are we really?
Yeah.
No.
No, we're not.
This is not a good joke. But the sink.
Yes, we are saving the sink. You got it? I got coming through.
We're at Adam Truss studio.
Knock, knock.
He's a friend of mine, an incredible illustrator, and that's why I need to see him today. So the Bird Dog Cafe, when I'm thinking of the signage, I want a bird dog. Very Southern folklore.
Cool.
And when I think of like illustrative animal world.
It's me.
That is all you. Hey, Maggie. I don't think that Maggie looks like a bird dog necessarily.
No, she's definitely not.
She can't know... swim. She can't swim.
Can't swim.
God love her. You think of a pointer.
Right.
But then I also think of, do we want wings?
When I think about like a winged creature, I think of like a hood ornament. So like very streamlined.
I do love how very pointy this dog is, but I know for sure I want really heavy.
Like bold lines.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I like that. So then lettering. I think if it looks illustrative and part of the landscape, I would be happiest, but.
Okay.
That feels a little ornamental, but I like this direction. I'm winging it. I am bird dog winging it right now.
Did we get everything to the health department?
Oh yeah, it was a whole thing. I submitted an application, the plans, the equipment.
It's good that they're thorough. This is a business. In the same way that we're being diligent about ADA codes, we need to be diligent about making sure that it's a safe place to eat.
The only thing that I am worried about are all of our porous surfaces in here. These wood floors that we're gonna refinish and reuse, wood countertops in the kitchen.
Might need stainless, right?
Yep, or some kind of wipeable surface. It's all about keeping it wipeable and clean. And then also all these wood walls that we decided to leave in the dining area. I just want you to wrap your mind around possible changes because right now we're just on hold in here until I hear back from the health department.
We have to hit pause on the walls, the countertops, the flooring. There's still a lot of stuff we can work on, like cabinets, trim work, installing doors.
There it is.
It looks good. It'll be even better when it's red. Today we're at River Prince's shop. We're gonna get to work on the bird dog signage. Has Adam sent over anything?
He has, yeah. So he sent this to me and I scaled it up.
So what I really want is for this logo to carry across two big old windows.
Okay.
What if we did the dog on one and the words on one?
Yeah, that's cool. That'll be the top half. When I work with illustrations from another artist, I always have them prepared like this.
River is a sign painter, and it's really a lost art.
So this is a lettering quill. These are used with oil-based paints.
Well, this is having like a real reconnaissance, isn't it? Like,
definitely.
Not reconnaissance, renaissance.
Yeah, I agreed with you. I was like, yeah. Definitely.
No,
yeah.
Sign painting is having a real renaissance,
for
right?
Sure.
For many decades, it became something that people weren't interested in because technology and you could print signage, but now, you're seeing a return to that craft of painting signs by hand, and he's one of the best. Just white on the glass, I think, is gonna be perfect.
It's gonna be really cool to see a traditional sign painter style paired with an illustration like this.
I think Elliot and Connor are gonna think it's super cool that we chose to use old windows and do hand-painted signage. I think it's gonna be really on brand for them.
This room's looking good.
I mean, it's kind of done.
I like this.
This is the room we want to stay in.
This is the room where we talk business.
Speaking of business, let's talk about the health department. Okay, what's the update? They're shutting us down. Totally. We're gonna have to rethink everything. The wood walls, the wood countertops, all of it.
You're joking.
Yeah, I'm joking. You're the worst.
What is wrong with you?
A lot.
It's good.
Good news. We get to keep all the wood walls, and we can do butcher block countertop as long as we seal them.
Amazing. Oh, sweet.
As long as it's wipeable, we can use it.
I love it.
Woo, that made me.
That was fun.
We've never done a restaurant before. That could have been the 100% truth.
That just made me feel like I was gonna throw up.
It feels like blue skies ahead now. Like, I have a clear vision for what this is going to be for sure now, not just hoping and assuming. Because you know what they say about assuming.
You shouldn't do it.
Oh my gosh, oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh.
Wow.
Can you believe it?
Yeah, this is, no, I can't believe it actually. What am I? The walls are just.
Those were a surprise.
The red molding kills it too.
Was there a wall here at
some point? There was a wall, you see the scene?
Were those from the...
They came from
some
the barn.
Some of them from the barn.
Yeah.
Some of them from this house.
Some of them house. From this house. We wanted to create just a little bit of a divider.
Yeah, that's super unique.
Aren't these floors incredible?
Yeah, is this what was in here?
Yes.
Yes.
Goodness gracious. And I love the
cross of
the wood. Yeah, that's really incredible. It's going to be a focal point when you walk in. Emmy Lou. Oh, y'all tried to make me cry now.
Emmy Lou?
We adopted her when she was a little bitty baby. She's 8 now. She's an actual bird dog.
Emmy Lou deserves a spot on our wall here for sure. See the wine storage on the wall there? That's really cool.
Oh, wow.
Oh, the signage. I got together with Adam and River Prince to talk about like what this brand should be and what it should feel like.
That's pretty cool.
Wow. So, kind of in shock right now.
Yeah.
I want to go in the kitchen.
Yeah, I do too.
I want you to look at it, see what you think. You got your bar here that you wanted. This is going to be me watching Elliot cook, asking for things. Come on in. Double swinging door.
Wow.
Look at that.
Yeah, this is amazing. That is beautiful.
Obviously, we worked with the health inspector. Everything is up to code. But as far as like the layout.
Coffee station, hot food station, cold food station, point of sale, and expo.
You've done a great job. The big thing I like is the fact that you can stand in the kitchen and see every seat in the place because we want to know that everybody's having the experience we want them to have.
And I made these little menu boards so you can put them on the tables. And that way, you can just replace this weekly if you want to change your menu, if it's a seasonal sort of thing.
We're super stoked to get in here and get our hands dirty in this kitchen. Wow.
It feels like more space than I was imagining.
I mean, you can comfortably work 4 people in here for sure.
Easily that.